telly, and I just got done watching 1988's A Fish Called Wanda, starring John Cleese, Jamie Lee Curtis, Kevin Kline, and Michael Palin. This one I've seen many times over the years. I essentially grew up with this movie. It's your classic kind of British comedy thing. Much in the same vein as other stuff that John Cleese has written, which he did for this movie. It's basically the story of four burglars who one of them gets locked up, George, and the other three, Ken, Otto, and Wanda, are like trying to. Otto and Wanda are working together against the others, kind of thing. They want to. They're having an affair, but they pretend they're brother and sister, and they turn George in. And then try to get the jewels that have been stolen for themselves. Except, of course, George doesn't trust Otto and has kind of, moved the jewels elsewhere. And the only person that knows, except for George, is Ken, played by Michael Palin, who's got a bad stutter and is a huge animal lover. It's basically kind of, you've got Otto and Wanda trying to, it's kind of like the Brits versus the Yanks. You've got the two Americans, trying to get the jewels for themselves, while the Brits are like, no, we want them. John Cleese plays Archie, George's barrister. Wanda sees that if she, her logic is that if she gets to know the barrister, that if George is going to tell anybody where the loot is, he's going to tell Archie. So she starts getting friendly with Archie, who's this kind of, I do wonder about John Cleese's psyche, because whenever he tends to write and play these character, these guys that are downtrodden by their domineering wives. He had that in 40 Towers and now in this. And he was exceptionally, in Clockwise, he was exceptionally kind of harassed, if you will. She starts going with Archie, but of course Otto's really jealous, and in the meantime Ken, who can't stand Otto, is dealing with the fact that there's this old lady that saw George in the getaway car. So she's a witness, she can give testimony at the trial and stuff. So at George's behest, Ken is out to try and kill the old lady. That and Otto has bet that Ken won't do it, so Ken is extra driven to kind of do this. Except every attempt, there's like three attempts, and instead of killing the old lady, he accidentally kills one of her little kind of Yorkies, one of her little dogs. So he's absolutely devastated each time one of the dogs dies. I'm not really describing this very well, but it is, it's kind of classic in its own way. I have a cat playing around my feet at the moment, so if I suddenly scream out, she's probably decided to claw me. sorry, quick side note. I grew up with this movie. It's nice to see Cleese and Palin opposite each other. They don't really have any scenes together. There's one bit at the end where they're talking to each other. But you don't really... It's nice to see them in the same movie together. It's not a laugh-out-loud film. I remember laughing at it a lot more when I was younger. But it's not... it's not laugh out loud hilarious. It's not as comedic as, say, Monty Python or Cleese's other work. But this is a lot of fun. It's really silly and a lot of fun. Kevin Klein has so much energy in this. It's almost infectious. I feel bad for Jamie Lee Curtis. She looks like a kind of, not meaning to pun on the title of the movie, but she does look like a bit like a fish out of water at times. But it's that's not her. She's not bad at acting at this. But it just does feel sometimes like she's a bit miscast is the wrong term, but it just sometimes doesn't feel like she fits in quite well. No, everybody's excellent in this. It's funny having Jeffrey Palmer in yesterday's Mrs. Brown, and then he turns up briefly as the judge in this. And even a very, very brief cameo by him, Stephen Fry, is good to see, you know. But this is, it's enjoyable. There's nothing bad about this movie. It's not amazing, it's not great. In that it's not, you know, some kind of perfect piece of film. Occasionally it does feel really cliched. I think it's that kind of thing when you get used to seeing, certainly John Cleese, the way he presents himself a lot. Sometimes you get used to seeing the same characters, but he seems to have a much tender side in this. Whereas, say, in 40 Towers, Basil is very, he's downtrodden, but he has serious anger issues. Here he's playing a character who's a lot more sympathetic. And, I mean, his wife's not as bad in this as Sybil was in that. But you do kind of, these characters are so kind of lovable in their own way. Even, you know, when they're being complete douches like Otto. But yeah, no, it's just really a lot of fun. It's a silly romp. And it's an hour and 40 minutes long, so we're not even talking about anything that's particularly lengthy to sit through. If you like your comedies, if you like your British comedies, there's a lot of putting down Brits in this. We are very good at, you know, kind of self-effacing, kind of putting our, self-deprecating, sorry. Us Brits are very good at self-deprecating, and a lot of what's said sometimes does ring quite true, which is kind of funny considering how sometimes, you know, some of the other stuff I've said more recently. But, yeah, no, if you like your British comedies, if you like... say stuff like Clockwise or John Cleese's other work. If you're looking for something with Kevin Klein having a bit of fun, this is definitely worth checking out. I don't think I really have any complaints about this movie. It cracks me up that it's a 15 rating, and all I can assume is because of the repeat use every now and then of the F word. That's the only reason why I can think this would have a 15 rating. Well, other than John Cleese stripping down at one point. But anyway, they did try to recreate this when they did Fierce Creatures years later with the same cast. I mean, even the poster... it kind of matches this. I have not seen Fierce Creatures. I've got the novelisation of the movie, but I've not actually, I don't think I've ever seen the movie, so I can't comment on that. But it's kind of sad in a way that they tried to recreate this, and as far as I know, they didn't get quite as close as they would have liked. But this is definitely worth checking out, like I say. Don't expect something laugh out funny. I think, again, as with everything, humour is very subjective and it's very individual to each person. like I said, I used to laugh my butt off to this movie. It could be that I've seen it so many times. It could be because I was younger then, and this is good fun for you know, younger teens and stuff like that. Or like I say, I was a kid when I first saw this. So, but it is, it's just, I can't, I wish there was something I could say other than it's fun or it's silly, because it is exactly those things, but I keep saying it and it's like, it's not having any different impact than the first time I said it. So I apologise for repeating myself, but that's all I can really say about this movie. It's just, yeah, it's just, if you want a good time, if you this is an afternoon movie. If you want a good afternoon movie, then this is definitely worth checking out. That's 1988's A Fish Called Wanda. Thank you so much, as always, for watching. Looking forward, as well, as always, to reading your comments and stuff. Please comment if you've seen Fierce Creatures. Let me know what that's like. But other than that, we'll be back again tomorrow. I don't know what it is, actually. I think it's another comedy. So, looking forward to that. But for now, this is Sketch, signing out.